Alright folks, Jonathan here. Now this is video number one in a couple I'm going to be doing on what is known as the fader start. Now the bit of kit we've got here, we've got the DJM-400 and we've got the CDJ-800 Mark II. Now then, as you can see on the mixer, we have the left hand side channel up like so. Now, but we haven't got any music playing. The reason being, I just want you to imagine that we've got music playing and we're going to do a bit of a mix. We're not going to mix, we're just going to pretend we are. The main reason for this video is to show you the concept, the idea, the initial idea behind the usage of fader start. Also, we've got the crossfade set to through, the through position. Now, what that means is that wherever the crossfade is, it won't be used. It can be in the middle, it can be on the right-hand side, the left-hand side. The crossfade now isn't being used at all. The only way of actually getting sound is by messing around with the two volume controls. Now then, without the use of fader start, this is what we would have to do. Let's say again, the left-hand side is playing. We will press start and then bring the volume up, and we can hear the music playing. Volume back down, no music. Volume up, music. Back down, no music. And again, with the volume down, if we've set channel the headphone to channel 2, we will still be able to hear it through the headphones. The music will still be playing, as you can see there, but the punters, the people listening, the dance floor, the main speakers won't have any sound coming out of it because the volume is set down to 0. And again, as we increase the volume, we can hear the music. Volume back down, we can't hear anything. We'll press Q again. Now then, if I now press fader start. Now, first of all as well, very important, what I've done, there is a cable fitted into this particular CDJ, and it's going out of the CDJ and into this mixer. Now then, also, you don't have to have this cable fitted, okay? The cable does come with the CDJ, but you don't have to have it. You can unplug it, plug it in, whenever you want, okay? Now then, as you can see now, we've got a button that's lit up. Right, now watch the difference. Now, finger on the actual volume control, and here we go. Bring the volume down, volume back up again, volume down. Now, two things are happening. One is that I'm not having to, with my other hand, press play. What's happening is as soon as I move my finger that's on the actual volume control up, the music starts. Bring it back down and it stops. Starts, stops. That's number one. That's the first thing that's happening. The second thing that's happening is that when I bring the volume back down, the actual CDJ goes back to its original position. So if you have a listen again, okay, this is video number one. It's a basic feature showing you the principle and showing you almost what the fader start actually does. Okay, like I said, video number one. Thanks for watching. Practice and enjoy.